Bay. It'd be very impressive.
It would indeed, but a great showing so far by Texas Tornado. He hasn't allowed himself to become overawed by the Barbarian. The Tornado has stuck to this with a lot of grim determination. We're yet to see his gale force type attack. Maybe this is it.
Comes off the ropes with a shoulder block. Again, here's a Tornado punch. And you saw the force behind that blow. Nearly swept the Tornado right out of the ring.
But he came back with a tremendous boot to the jaw, and I wouldn't be surprised if that hasn't relieved a few of the teeth in the mouth of the Tornado. Oh, gosh.
Jack to the throat, takes Kerry Von Erich right off his feet.
Some really damaging blows here by the Barbarian, and I'm surprised that the Texas Tornado is still able to withstand his barrage. But he does, and he's still trying to hang in. He must be very, very misty upstairs. A lot of cobwebs there, Sean.
Now the Tornado. Under the boots. The Barbarian, as he rolls out of the ring. Safe haven at this point.
It is. A lot of respite should be due to the Tornado here. The referee should definitely not be counting him. I say should not be, but he was. And still is.
Jimmy's account. Look at determination there on the face of the Tornado. Did not see the Barbarian slip out and come up from behind him. Hard into the chair.
And Howard Finkel there, the Finkster, ran for his dear life. Tornado in a lot of trouble there outside the ring. Not quite sure of his location. And very, very, as I said before, misty upstairs. A lot of clouds there. However, the referee showing a lot of tolerance with both men here and allowing Texas Tornado some respite on the outside, but not the Barbarian.
Texas Tornado just trying to get his wits together. The Barbarian is not giving him the opportunity. As Von Erich attempted to get back into the squared circle, Barbarian just wandered over and connected a boot to his head.
Yes, he's sort of casually observing his victim now, almost as one would observe a prey. Look at Tornado, he is really striving now to gather some reserve energy and force.
Slow and calculating, the Barbarian taking his time. Brings up the Tornado.
What a powerful effort that was by the Barbarian. No leverage at all, that was just brute strength and power to bring in the Texas Tornado. But look at Tornado, still hanging in.
Full count of two. Before the Tornado can get that shoulder off the canvas. Barely hanging on at this point.
Another suplex coming up.
Looks as though that is exactly what he's setting up the Tornado for. Tornado turns it around, rolls up the Barbarian. And you talk about perfect timing on the part of the Tornado. Here's the official word. About that, your lordship, is that Kerry Von Erich let the Barbarian set him up for that suplex, waited to the last second, and then just collapsed, rolling up the Barbarian and getting the victory. Now here's another look.
Well, what happened was there, the Barbarian was shaping his man up. You could almost see him thinking to throw him backwards outside the ring. The Tornado didn't allow that to happen and brought him over in a small package. A tremendous victory for the Tornado.
A lot of excitement in that encounter, and Bobby Heenan, being an unbiased broadcast journalist, I'm sure would agree that was a great encounter between the Texas Tornado and the Barbarian.
I don't like the Tornado. I don't like what the guy stands for. He's the kind of a guy that at any given time can knock you off. He's a very capable athlete. But he's from Texas. Anybody from Texas is...
no belt.
Find it?
Still missing.
Apparently. Well, things are narrowing down very nicely. You see, we have searched this entire building high and low.